The series finale of a show can leave a very positive or negative impact on a dedicated fan. Some great examples of a finale are The Weirdmageddon from Gravity Falls and Come Along With Me from Adventure Time. Sadly, some great shows are forced to rush their finales or not even have one due to cancellations. Sometimes a finale just turns out to be bad if the focus of the show is more on having viewers than quality, because they can't lose or gain many viewers. However, if done right, an amazing finale can give a show a renaissance, sometimes to the point of related content being released and succeeding years later. How do these principles combine with Star vs. the Force of Evil? What can us, as fans, do to benefit the show? We can share our ideas and let them blossom. So what do some of us fans believe will happen? Let's find out.
First, let's start with deducing who the villain will be. The main villain suspects are Eclipsa, Globgore, Toffee, and Monster Arm. It's easy to conclude that Monster Arm slash Marco will not be the main villain. Star vs. the Forces of Evil is the kind of show to have that much plot continuity. Steven Universe clearly knew what it wanted to do from the first episode, as an action Steven makes ends up affecting his life majorly later. Star Butterfly's actions in Season 1 have very little effect on far future of the series. While it is true that Monster Arm said he would be back and Star brushed it off, Star vs. the Force of Evil does not have extreme continuity. Due to his actions, Monster Arm is most likely a type of fungal parasite. However, Monster Arm does not need a specific location to grow, like fungal parasites. It only needs a broken bone, as proven by the description in the official book Star and Marco's Guide to Mastering Every Dimension. The name of the spell is made to look like Latin, and is Release Demon Infection, without the extra letters added for that fancy effect. The spell used to counteract this is called Returnius Arm Normoso. If the demon is in the arm, and the arm is turned back to normal, the demon is gone. It's simple. Also, it would likely be very complicated if the love interest was the villain.
Next up, Toffee will likely not be the villain either. Just like Monster Arm, he's dead. Can he regenerate himself? Yes, but we see his body on screen and it's too mangled to restore itself. At least not without some magic. Unlike the show, the book claims he wants the wand. Is this to try and regenerate himself fully, as he knew where his finger was? We can only speculate. Either way, there is almost no way the goop he became can regenerate, unless that goop is the same goop found in the wand. Next up is Globgore. Globgore is an interesting case. We know almost nothing about him and how he acts. He could be a ruthless monster or a kind person who's been framed as evil. Considering the direction the show is headed, monsters and humans uniting, it's likely he will turn out to be just misunderstood. Eclipse is also an odd case. Attentive fans have noticed how much more she expresses her feelings as the season continues. It's clear that this more emotional side is the real Eclipsa, and the perky childish side was likely a shell. Could she have a similar aspect, but with her being evil? It's possible. At the end of the day, there's too much we don't know to predict how Season 4 will play out and the series will end. A villain is unclear, and it could be anything from discontent with Mutant Prejudice to a showdown with the Monster King. Either way, one thing is for certain. It's gonna get a little weird, it's gonna get a little wild. Star vs. the Force of Evil is going out with a bang.